Good morning. In this video, I am going to explain about web servers. Sun Microsystems proposed three modules of Java. First one is J2SC, second one is J2EE, and the third one is J2ME. J2SC means Java 2 Standard Edition. J2EE means Java 2 Enterprise Edition. J2ME means mobile, or which we can say that micro edition. So Sun Microsystems proposed three modules of Java: J2SC, J2EE, J2ME. What is J2SC? J2SC is a technology means it is already implemented one. We can download it from the net and we can install it to our system. Second one is J2EE. J2EE is not a technology, it is a specification. This is the important interview question. J2EE is not a technology, it is a specification. What is the difference between technology and specification? Technology means already implemented one. We can download from the net and we can install into our system directly. Whereas specification is a document. Specification is a document that is released into the public market before starting the project. So different vendors takes this specification and they have implemented in their own way. J2EE specification was given by Sun Microsystems. J2EE specification was given by Sun Microsystems. Because of the popularity of Sun Microsystems, different vendors take this specification and they have implemented in terms of web servers and application servers. So J2EE specification is from Sun Microsystems that is released into the public market before starting the project. So different vendors take that specification and they have implemented this J2EE specification in terms of web servers and application servers. Here, one of the interview question is, did you ever install J2EE? Important interview question is, did you ever install J2EE? If you say yes, then that will be the last question for you. The answer is no. Why? Because J2EE is not a technology, it is a specification. It is not possible to install the specification. Why? Because it is simply a document. What is a web server? Web server is a piece of software that resides on the server and listens to the clients continuously in a 24/7 format. If you observe carefully the definition, it has three points. First one is it is a software. Second one is it resides on the server. Third one is listens to the clients continuously. In a 24/7 format. What is a software? Set of programs or instructions which when executed it provides some function and performance. So it is a software. What is the second point? It resides on the server. Resides on the server means whenever we are installing the web server into the server, it is stored into the server's hard disk. Third one is listens to the clients continuously in a 24/7 format. Whenever the client gives the request to the web server, it takes the request. After processing, it sends the response back to the client. In which format? 24/7 format. What is meant by 24/7 format? 24 hours per a day and 7 days per a week. A day contains how many hours? 24 hours. A week contains how many days? 7 days. So it can work for 24 hours and 7 days. That means it can listen to the clients continuously.
So this is the server. We are installing the web server into the server's hard disk. And whenever the client gives the request to the web server, it takes the request. If necessary, it connects to the database. And then it sends the response back to the client. Here, what is meant by a web client?
Web client is nothing but a web browser. It is a software used to access the files and information from the World Wide Web through internet. Web clients are nothing but web browsers used to access the information from the World Wide Web through internet. So different web clients are Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Safari, and so many browsers. All these are nothing but web clients.
Web servers contains a list of web applications, where web applications are nothing but projects. Each and every web application contains a list of web resources. Web resources are nothing but programs. There are two types of web resources, which will generate the static content and which will generate the dynamic content. So hierarchical structure is, web servers contains a list of web applications, where web applications are nothing but our projects. Each and every web application contains a list of web resources. Web resources are nothing but programs. Web resources are how many types? Two types. Which generates the static content and which generates the dynamic content. Coming to the static content, we can develop the static content web pages or websites by using HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. We can generate the dynamic content by using server-side technology programs.
Server-side technologies are two types. One is process-based technologies and second one is thread-based technologies. So coming to the process-based technologies, for each and every client request, separate process is created. Assume that if the request is coming from the client C1, for the client C1, P1 process is created and this process is connected to the web application where it sends the response back to the client. If the request is coming from the client C2, another process is created, that is P2. It connects to the web application and then it sends the response back to the client. Next, if the request is coming from the same client again, that is from C1, second time request. For C1, already which process is created? P1. But it never makes use of an existing process. Simply, it will create the new process if the request is coming from the same client. So, for the client C1, it will create the new process P3. Already P1 is created for which one? Client C1. But it never makes use of an existing process. Simply it will create the new process and then it connects to the web application. It sends the response back to the client. That means for each and every client request, separate process is created. What are the drawbacks of this one? First one is control jumping. Control jumping is also known as context switching. Jumping from one process to another process takes a lot of time. That is nothing but the first drawback of this approach. And the second drawback is, for every client request, separate process is created. If client C1 gives the request to the web application 10 number of times, how many processes will be created? 10 processes will be created. Okay? So unnecessarily burden on the server will increase. So second drawback is burden on the server. So to overcome these two drawbacks of process-based technologies, next one is thread-based technologies. Coming to the thread-based technologies, if a client gives the request to the web application or web server, it creates a thread as part of the main operating system process. This is the main operating system process. Assume the request is coming from the client C1. it creates a thread T1 as part of the main operating system process and then connects to the web application. After processing, it sends the response back to the client. Assume that for the client C2, it will create a thread T2. It connects to the web application and then it sends the response back to the client. Here important point is, if the request is again coming from the C1, for the C1 already which thread is created? T1. So it makes use of an existing thread. It never creates a new thread. Okay. So if the request is coming again from the client C1, it makes use of an existing thread T1 and then it connects to the web application where it sends the response back to the client. What are the drawbacks of the previous approach? Control jumping takes a lot of time. First one here. Control jumping between the threads takes a less time when compared to the processes. Web server contains two containers. One is servlet container to process the servlets. Second one is JSP container to process the JSP programs. From the interview point of view, these two are the important interview questions. What is an application server? What is the difference between web server and application server? So what is an application server? An application server is also a piece of software that resides on the server and listens to the clients continuously in a 24/7 format. The definition of an application server is same as web server. Then what is the difference between web server and application server? So web server contains how many containers? Two containers. Servlet container as well as JSP container. Coming to the application server contains how many containers? Three containers. Servlet container, JSP container, as well as important one is EJB container. So an application server is equal to web server plus EJB container plus some responsibilities like connection pooling, security, and so on. So what is an application server? An application server is nothing but web server plus EJB container plus some number of responsibilities like a connection pooling and security. Important interview question is, does every web server act as an application server? Answer is no. Second question is, does every application server act as a web server? Yes. Answer is yes. Next. What is a web application? What is a web application? And what is an enterprise application? These two are also important interview questions. What is a web application and what is meant by an enterprise application? So coming to the first one is, what is a web application? If you develop the application by using servlets and JSPs, those kind of applications are known as web applications. Web applications are nothing but small internet applications. What is an enterprise application? If we develop the application by using EJBs, those kind of applications are known as enterprise applications. So enterprise applications are nothing but large internet applications. Examples are banking applications. Coming to the web applications, we can deploy the web applications either in web servers or in application servers. Whereas coming to the enterprise applications, we must deploy enterprise applications only in application servers. Why? Because application server only contains the EJB container. That's why in order to deploy the enterprise applications, we need application server only. Coming to this one, what are the important interview questions? What is an application server? What is the difference between web server and application server? What is a web application? What is an enterprise application? Does every web server act as an application server? No. Does every application server act as a web server? Yes. All these are the important interview questions.